What's up, everyone? Today we're going to talk about Azure Resource Manager templates. Keep watching.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back, and let's do some quick programming. Today we're going to cover Azure Resource Manager templates. If you want to learn more about them, click on the link below. I'm going to do a very rough overview of what an Azure Resource template is, and let's get to it. All right, so this is the bare bones of an ARM template. Basically, you can describe anything in Azure resource-wise via a template, from web apps to CDNs to databases and networks. The first thing that you'll notice is the schema. The schema is used by Azure to essentially reinforce the structure of the template. The content version is the version of the template that you're building. I'm going with 1.0.0.0. If this was version 8 of my template, then I would say 8.0.0.0. The next section is parameters. Parameters are used to basically allow users to pass in data when deploying the templates. Variables are similar to parameters, but essentially you can pass in without requiring user input. So if you know that you always want your database name to be MyCars database, then you would put it in a variable. However, you probably shouldn't do that. It's not best practice. Please go with parameters for the overall. Resources are your actual resources. So resources describe things such as websites, databases, and anything else in Azure that you can build. The output section is for values that are returned after deployment. I haven't found much need for these. However, they are very beneficial in the long run if you're doing a very complex template. Let's get started on building an environment. In this environment, we're going to have a website with application insights, a database that connects to the website, a CDN, content delivery network, to house all our images for the website, and a service plan for the web app's pricing tier. The first thing that I'm going to want to do is, you'll notice that I'm running this in Visual Studio. I would recommend using Visual Studio and maybe even Visual Studio Code, but VS is even easier. There's a lot of built-in tools and we're about to see them. So right click resources, click add new resource, and the first thing that we're going to build is the service plan. And I'm going to give it a descriptive name, not the name for the resource, but a name that describes what the resource is. So I'm going to go really generic and say at LAN. Now we can see that there's been a new resource added. It has the parameter at LAN name, and it gives a little bit more detail into all this stuff. A lot of this stuff you don't have to worry about. The Visual Studio just kind of puts it in for you, and you don't have to worry about it. The parameters that have been added are the plan name, the plan SKU, which is essentially the pricing tier, and the plan worker size. You can also see that there's default values for the plan SKU and worker size. We'll use those values for now. The next thing we're going to do is right click on resources again, and this time we're going to create a web application. Scroll all the way down and click web app, and then once again I'm going to say something really generic but descriptive, web app. And now you can see that the web app's resource has been added. I'm going to continue with adding an application insights for my web app. You can see that for application insights, it's required that you already have an app service plan and a web app. I do, and so I don't have to create another one. If I wanted to, I could click the drop down and create new or select from a subscription that I already have in Azure. I'm going to go ahead and click add, and now you can see that there's been a bunch added in here. And the bulk of it is these rules that are now in here. This is the actual app insights, and these are alerts that the tooling just kind of added in there automatically. There's other alerts that you can have, and you can definitely modify the alerts that currently were just added in. All right, so let's create a database. Click resources, add new resource, and scroll down for the database. I'm going to create a MySQL database. It is the only one in this tool. And finally, I'm going to create a CDN endpoint and kind of show you when a resource needs a dependency, how you can easily manage that. So a CDN endpoint requires a CDN profile. In here, I'm going to give the endpoint a name, and you can see that right now the CDN profile is blank. You can create new or once again select from your subscription in Azure. I'm not going to do that. So if you click new, then it just brings you right to the template creation for profile. And I'm going to say CDN profile in here. Click add. It brings you back to the CDN endpoint just in case you want to change anything in here. And it clicks add there. Now, for this exercise, I noticed when I was doing my research that it's throwing exceptions. And this is due to the schema. The schema isn't liking something in here. And like it gives you clear definition of what the problem is. However, if I go ahead and remove profiles and control space, then you can see that microsoft.cdn/profiles is a valid entry. So it's complaining, but it's fine. There's nothing wrong with it, and it will work whenever we put it into Azure. So here we are in Azure. I'm going to go into more services, type up here template, and you can see that there is a resource for or a service for templates. I'm going to go ahead and favorite it so it shows up here. And you can see I have no templates to display at the moment. Let's go ahead and add one. You can give it a generic name. I'm going to say it's my website's definition. And you have to give it a description as well. The description I'm going to put in there is going to describe what all is in here. You can put whatever you want in here. I just find that when you describe what is in your template, it's very helpful. So now we go in and Azure wants you to basically paste in your template, or you can put it in, you can actually develop in here if you wanted to, which I think is a little bit harder, but you can if you want, like I said. So I went ahead and I copied all the changes that we made and I'm going to paste them in here, and then you just click OK. You can see that it validated fine. It showed that really quick. And now we're ready to add the template. So just click add, and the template's been saved, but it doesn't display here. So that's a little strange, but all you have to do is hit refresh, and now you can see my website's definition, and you can see everything that's in it, which makes it super easy. If I wanted to deploy the template, then I can go in here and click deploy, or if I wanted to edit, I can easily edit or delete, and you can even share this with other people. I'm going to go ahead and deploy to walk you through that process. It's a little bit different from deploying each individual resource. So your plan name is going to be your service plan name, right? And I'm going to just give it a basic name such like my website's QP for quick programming. You can see that there's free, shared, basic, and standard for the SKU, just like we saw in the template. I'm going to stay with free. And we see 0, 1, and 2 for the worker size. My database name is going to be QPDB. And my database SKU is going to be free as well. It's a little confusing because these names, Jupiter, Saturn, and Venus, are not exactly intuitive. But you can think of them along the lines of Jupiter's the biggest, then Saturn, then Venus, and of course free is free. So Jupiter costs the most, Saturn is slightly cheaper, and Venus is the cheapest of the paid. And then your origin URL. This is something that you didn't really notice in the template, but it is in there as a parameter. It's essentially where your images are currently stored. So I don't have any place like that, so I'm just going to say quickprogramming.devinchase.me, which is my website, and I am going to click OK. I'm going to call this QPRG for resource group, and you have to click legal terms and wait for it to load and click purchase because we have a CDN and CDNs cost money. Once that's done, I'm going to click pin to dashboard and create. Once that's finished, it's going to show up on your dashboard. You can see now that it's still deploying. Once that's done, it'll pop open your resource group and you can see everything that's been created in there. Alright everyone, thanks for watching. If you like this video, please hit the like button. If you like this channel in general, please subscribe.